Hello and welcome to the Banker's Top 1000 World Banks Ranking 2022. I'm Joy Macknight, editor of The Banker. After our data analysts on the Banker database have crunched the numbers, the headline result is that it has been a stellar year for the global banking industry. The aggregate Tier 1 capital of the world's 1,000 biggest banks has surpassed $10 trillion for the first time in the history of the ranking, demonstrating that the global banking system is better capitalized than ever before. In addition, aggregate total assets have broken the $150 trillion barrier for the first time. Profits saw a healthy rebound, with aggregate pre-tax profits reaching a record-breaking $1.44 trillion. This is a 53.7% year-on-year increase. So a record-breaking year on many fronts. But let's talk about Africa. With me in the studio is John Everington, Africa and the Middle East editor for The Banker. John, thanks so much for joining me.
Good to be here, Joy.
So what was sort of the headline results for Africa this year?
Well, first of all, it's been a much better year for Africa than it was in last year's rankings. Last year, the pandemic really hit key markets hard, and you saw a lot of African banks slipping back in the rankings, but also having real impact on their Tier 1 capital positions. This year, it's been a much brighter picture. Like their peers elsewhere, you've seen profitability increasing as the provisions get lower, as there's a tentative recovery in many markets. You've seen 18 out of the top 25 banks in the region improve their rankings in the overall rankings, which is always good to see compared with their peers elsewhere. That being said, we have seen some interesting slowdowns within key markets within Africa, which are actually going to kind of intensify as the year goes on. So that's been a noticeable trend as well.
Okay. So let's take a look at the regional table. Mm-hmm. You know, were there many changes at the top?
Well, once again, Standard Bank, it's been the top bank in Africa for, I think, the last 20-something years. And it's the top bank this year as well. So congratulations to them. So they've done very well in the pandemic. Last year, they were one of the few South African banks, the few major South African banks to register an increase in their Tier 1 capital. And they've done it again this year as well, albeit at quite a slow rate. Mm-hmm. But they still have done enough to maintain that top spot, which is going to be theirs for a little while, we think. First Rand, who are the second largest lender in South Africa, they actually recorded a very, very strong showing in the overall rankings in terms of their Tier 1 position. It has to be said that that did come as a result of currency fluctuations with what the Rand was doing in their reporting period, but still a good result for them. Absa, coming in third position as they did last year. And National Bank of Egypt, who entered the top five a year or two ago, they are now strengthening their position and they're very, very close to that third position. So we're going to have to see what's going to happen in the next year rankings.
Okay. And then who were the region's highest movers?
I think maybe let's start off with saying where there isn't growth this year. Egypt, as we always say in these videos, has been a market which has seen incredible growth in North Africa, particularly since the devaluation of the pound in 2016. Mm. That ushered in a lot of kind of growth for the large banks, double-digit Tier 1 capital increases. That has not really been the case this year. The tide is starting to shift. There is growth there. They are still continuing to grow. The increases are not the sort of double-digit increases that we've seen before. It's only CIB in the top 25 who's seen that double-digit increase. All the other ones are slightly lower. And that's also a pattern that we've seen within wider North Africa as well. The two Moroccan banks who are up there in the top rankings, they are still continuing to grow. It's not as dramatic as it has been in the past, so that has slowed somewhat. What's also interesting to note is Nigeria, you are seeing some growth there. There has been some sort of like growth. And I think what really needs to be mentioned is Access Bank, who have now kind of converted their structure and now Access Holdings. They saw an increase of 45% in Tier 1 capital, a very, very large increase over the past year. This has been impacted by a series of acquisitions that they've been doing across the African continent, boosting their footprint. So they saw 131 places increase in the main rankings to 499th. There has been some growth in Nigeria, but again, it's been a little bit more mixed. But Access Holdings has really kind of captured that sort of growth, I would say, in this year.
Excellent. So thank you so much for your insights, John.
Thank you, Joy.
The Banker's Top 1000 World Banks has been setting the industry benchmark since 1970. The ranking identifies the top 1000 biggest banks and is the definitive guide to identifying which banks are the strongest in the world based on more than 120 data points tracked in the Banker database year on year. We analyze results by region, country, and benchmark bank to bank, as well as run our best performing bank methodology to help identify a bank's strengths and weaknesses compared to its peers. To get access to our Top 1000 World Banks 2022 content and data, you can view our special offers by visiting thebanker.com/top1000offers.